influenced us greatly. I mean, that's where it all came from.
Yeah, a lot from the blues side of it, yeah. Blues and the early rock and roll.
Well, really the stepping stones, you know, towards the music the way it is today. Jump in!
Don't think the likes of Howlin' Wolf or Elvis Presley had AC/DC in mind when they were laying down the foundation of rock and roll. Yet Australia's arena rock gods have endured for 22 years and are back in America to kick off their Fall Breaker World Tour, with 70% of the band's set list coming from their latest release.
The rest of it, apart from that, is all, you know, from all our albums. We've still been doing songs, even from our first album. We've, you know, there's lots of songs that people know us for, and we still play them.
Keeping the rhythm going this time out is original AC/DC drummer Bill Rudd, who's back after a 14-year absence.
Our last tour of the world, we finished up in New Zealand. That's his home base, you know. And he said then he would really love to do it again, you know. And, you know, we thought, great, you know, let's go.
And how did Chris Slade, AC/DC's last drummer, take the news?
Well, Chris is a good drummer, but he's also a professional guy too, you know. And he knew that it's not I mean, we all got along great with Chris as a person. And he knew it was just a different style, you know, for what we are. And Phil does it best, you know. Any drummer we've even worked with in the past, you know, it's always been on the style Phil set. That's how he plays this way naturally, you know.
Yeah, he said it, didn't he?
Yeah.
He set that style and nobody can copy
it. Yeah, nobody can copy it.
Nobody can copy it, you see. Yeah.
I tried, but...
Wouldn't get me the gig either.
As for the crowd in Memphis, it was a hyper mix of seasoned veterans and first-timers.
Seen Back in Black, Highway to Hell, For Those About to Rock, a few more. Hey, Razor's Edge and this one.
It's my first concert. I'm excited.
Is this your first concert?
No.
Who have you seen before?
Garth Brooks.
Saw him here in Memphis 5 years ago.
And what was that show like?
It was great. It was killer. This one's going to be even better.
Absolutely wild. For this tour, we'll settle down into bigger venues and take the Swedish rockers to new and exciting parts of Europe.
We're going to play Warsaw and we're going to play Prague, and that'd be kind of interesting to just to see. I mean, see the ex-Eastern Bloc countries. I'm really looking forward to that. Speak the truth, don't you dare lie to me.
I've seen it all before, the way you disagree. It's 2 years since Clawfinger released their award-winning debut album, Deaf, Dumb and Blind. And for Use Your Brain, the band wanted to take their angry sound one step further.
We decided that the sound we had on the first record was maybe kind of personal for us. So we tried to just keep the sound, just do it a little better, a little fatter. And just concentrating on the songwriting, as I said.
Never change a winning concept. Second album is the first one we've been successful. But then once again, all you can do is do your best and do things, you know, if you're honest to you. Whether or not they get the same media attention that they're getting now, then I think, you know, this sort of crossover rap metal, whatever you want to call it, will stick around. And I think there definitely will be more and more interesting, you know, blends of music.
And the fact that I ate enough Valiums to probably put everybody in this room to sleep for about a week. And I at one period in my career was having a relationship with a French girl, and she gave me the words in French, and I carried those words with me forever. I finally applied them. Growing up, I thought that the Beatles and Michel was such a beautiful song because of the way that they applied it. Now, there's been heavy metal bands that sing in French that just suck. So it had to have been done very, very well. I hope that, you know, it, the translation is proper, and we'll know when we get to Paris if, you know, if they're clapping or if they're, you know, throwing shit bombs at us. But the video itself is really kind of like, you know, about what it would be like for me to sit at the edge of my grave and watch my whole life go in front of my eyes.
Obviously, we're very proud to be at, you know, like the pioneers of something. We put some foundations down which other people picked up, And the fact that like Metallica became superstars, and we don't mind it at all, do we?
Metallica exists, and who we, I'm not going to use the word stole, but who we were mostly inspired by.
I was in England and played with a band that's similar to our styles, you know.
It's good to see that people are coming to the show because it's Metallica, not just because it's a Donington thing, which is an event in itself, you know. But it's good to see a lot of crazy people here to see, you know, the good music that's going on today.
About another 4 weeks left in Europe, 15 shows, and it's great.
I mean, there's no huger pressure on ourselves than from ourselves, you know. I mean, all this crap about you have to sell more of the next record, you have to, you know, play bigger places, you know, have more statues, more explosions and crap. I mean, we're gonna write some great material, and that's the main thing that Metallica does, and the most important for Metallica is writing material.
Hi, Dave Mustaine from Megadeth here in Berlin at the first ever MTV European Music Awards. Today's going to be a very busy day. First of all, not only am I a presenter for one of the categories with one of the awards, but we're also doing a live one-off performance here. Let's take a look at today's festivities.
Like great backdrop, you know, this Berlin thing. I think it was cool. No one day I started telling everyone that killing is my business,
and I was hung like a lion. Just arrived at the gig, thanks to a friend of mine giving me a lift. Fortunately for me, he knew I was in Megadeth, so he gave me a ride. Unfortunately for me, he didn't like Megadeth, so he made me ride in the trunk. Now, I'm gonna be a part of history. I'm gonna jump the wall in Berlin. Come on, watch me. This would mean a thing, but some crazy shit has happened since I caught your head. Alright, here we are. We just got over the wall. I'm here with my partners in crime, David Ellison and Marty Friedman. Guys, have we ever entered a gig more ridiculously than this?
Tear down the wall.
I think we've left gigs crazier, but we've never entered any just like this.
So what did you guys think of the awards?
I think it's time to hear some Megadeth.
That's a great answer.
And are you ready to play new music for these fans in Germany?
I just drank 2 cups of coffee over at the club, and I'm fired up and ready to go.
Oh, that's a side of David Ellison I've never seen before there.
Look closely near his hair. You'll see little baby horns growing. We're ready to rock. And that's about it for my coverage for MTV tonight from Berlin, the first ever European Music Awards here. Anyways, I just want to give you a brief summary of what I felt was cool about our show. Walking back and seeing Nick Vomit right before we did Victory kind of made me think twice about singing real hard because I kept thinking about joining him. But for now, we're going to leave you with more Megadeth. Thank you for joining us. Well, I like the things that you try to fake. Oh, when you face what I see, you break. You say you will pray for me. You realize you are praying for me.
lot of trees around here. You start to feel kind of hemmed in, you know, in the end. Trees and trees and trees and trees and rocks and then occasional lake and then trees. So what it is really is, I've seen the Christmas trees. Can we see Santa now, you know?
I think festivals are fun. Enjoy yourself.
Get muddy. That's when you know you're at a bird festival, man, when they run out of mud.
Hej på er där, det här är Mickey D och ni kollar på Hultsfred sommarfestival weekend på MTV. Lem fattar ingenting såklart för han talar inte svenska. Well, he can tell you exactly the same thing in English.
Exactly the same thing?
Be good. How are you going to feel the next day? You say you really need me when they do close the door. You say you want to leave me when they do beg for more. Well, I ain't sentimental, so don't try to set a track. Cause every time you hurt me, you stab me in the back. Well, if you want my body, then just make love to my mind. Well, don't you try to hurt me, cause I wait the hurting kind. Well, I told you that I loved you, you didn't care at all. I needed you to touch me, but instead you crushed my balls. I love you, I hate you, I can feel my rage. Cheat and deceive you, I'll leave you. I love you, I hate you, I can feel my rage. You and I cheat and deceive, but I hate you. I hate you. I hate you. Tune for more on MTV Summer Festival Weekend.
The whole concept of the song and the way we record.
Well, I think
special.
When we first wrote, we wrote in buckets, plastic buckets, because
yeah.
We didn't have enough. We didn't want to take Igor's drum apart. So there's these buckets on the practice bed, so just like in Brazil in the bar
and
tables.
Fucking bollock sound. And the way we do Caiovas live too is without acoustic instruments.
It's a hell
we play
version.
With our.
The road Sepultura have taken to become one of the most popular bands in heavy metal. But traveling on that road to success has not been an easy one.
And Sepultura is a band really based on challenge since we first started. Anything that creates some kind of challenge, it's always good and motivating for us. And that's pretty much the reason when we said to the people in Brazil, we're gonna make it, we're gonna get out of here, we're gonna tour, and everybody thought we were complete out of our minds, you know, thought that, you know, look at those guys, they're living in a dream world, thinking that they're ever gonna even get out of Belo Horizonte. And we did it, you know, that's motivation, you know. Brazil is so full of suffering, so full of bad stuff, that sometimes you gotta bring something good out of it to try to balance that a little bit, because all you hear about Brazil, it's negative all the time. So, you know, we try to bring us something positive out of that country sometimes.
The band's fourth album, Chaos AD, has made them a favorite with European metal fans. But Sepultura are aware of the problems that fame can sometimes bring.
Everything has its price. And we knew that there'd be a price for all these. You don't get into these thinking that it's gonna be easy way and all that, so. I wanted to do that 10 years ago. I wanted to drop everything I had going, dedicate my entire time for music. But I knew that the minute we start working, it would always take more and more from us. I think you just gotta deal with it, and if you don't like it, the best thing you should do is stop and quit and totally go out of it.
It depends where we go, you know, and I try to manage that too, so I'm a pretty open person, so I pretty much don't have a problem with this. I just, everybody starts to talk to me, just buy me a beer and everything will be fine.
One of the highlights of the past 12 months for the band was their performance at Donington Monsters of Rock, complete with nerves and adrenaline.
The pressure of being the first third world band to play Donington, first South American band to play Donington, all that. I end up building the whole pressure, you know. But once you're on stage, that's it, then it was great. And the crowd was really good, really into Sepultura that day. We just, that's the best.
Apart from that,
rock, body rock, rock, body rock, go!
Some critics claim Sepultura could be as big as Guns N' Roses if Max Cavalera changed his vocal style. But Sepultura isn't about having massive commercial success.
It's my style. If I sing like Axl Rose, then I'm not going to be myself anymore. Then even if I sell more albums, I'm not myself, then why should I do? All we want to do right now is stick to our roots and write the music that we think is right. And that music, like I say, we're just going to find these right people. Somehow, the right people is going to find that music, too. That's the way for us. I don't expect everybody to like Sepultura. I know there's a lot of people that hate Sepultura, but there's a lot of people that like it a lot.